Hello, today I'm going to show you the basic principles of design in Shape3D. Let's start with a new board of the surfboard type, for example. When you open it in design mode, you have several views. So here we have the top view, and you have the side view, and also a cross-section view, which we call slice in Shape3D. You can have several defined cross-sections in different positions along X, X being the length of the board, and we have the list here at the bottom, and we can select them like this. So, in Shape3D, we can have one sole view like this, and we're going to go from one view to another with the button in the toolbar. You can also choose to have two panels to have two views, for example, top view and side view. Or even three panels to have, for example, top view, side view, and a cross-section view. And then you can change the respective sizes of these panels. At the bottom, here we have the master scale window, which gives the main dimensions of our board, and we can choose to display the master scale at the bottom, as shown here, or to display it on the side by clicking Tile Vertically. In this case, we have the master scale on the side, and then we click on the top view panel here. We have the list of the curves on the top view, and when we click on the side view, we have the list of the curves on the side view, and when we click on the slice panel, we have the list of slices. And you can see that each slice has control points. Here there are five, for example. You can click on the control points. It makes the tangent of the curve at this point appear. So this point can be moved with the mouse or arrow keyboard buttons, and similarly, the tangents can be moved with the mouse or arrow keyboard buttons. And you'll notice that each cross-section here has the same number of points. And in the top view panel, you can display each curve corresponding to each point of the slices. So, for example, here we have the apex curve displayed, which is also called the outline, which corresponds to the widest point of the cross-section. But we have also displayed the rail curve here in green, which corresponds here to the cross-section rail. But we can also display the deck one curve, for example, here, which corresponds to the control point on the top of this cross-section's rail. And it's the same on the side view. So we can also display the stringer bot curve here, which corresponds to the central point of the bottom of the slice. There is also the rail curve, the apex curve, deck one, and stringer top, which corresponds to the central point of the top of the slice. In the top view, you can see that we also have the outline dev curve, which corresponds to the outline of the board laid down flat. So we can make the connection with two modes of measurement that are there in Shape3D. There's the measurements along a straight line mode of measurement. You can see that in this case, the board is 6.08 long. And if we click on Measurements along the stringer, then the board is longer. It is 6.153 long. So the difference is we either measure the length along a straight horizontal line along the length of the board, or we measure the lengths along the stringer bot curve here. So the curve along the bottom of the board on the central axis. And so obviously, when we measure along the stringer on the bottom curve, the length is greater than when we measure along a straight line. Here in side view, you can see that we can also display the profile bot curve, which corresponds to the lowest point of each cross section. You can click here to display it, and click on the two arrows here to change the color. For example, we can display it in red. And so you can see here that the profile bot curve is below the stringer bot curve, because the board is concave here. But on the other hand, at the back, the board has a V shape, and so the profile bot curve blends into the stringer bot curve. And similarly, we can display the profile top curve, which corresponds to the highest point of each cross-section. And you can see here that as the deck is convex, it still blends in with the stringer top curve. So each of the curves here corresponds with a point on the slices. And you can appreciate it thanks to the wire view. So if you click here, now you can see the board with each of the curves that link the control points of each slice. And so if we put this wire view on its side, we get all the curves in the side view. If we put it in top view, we get all the curves in the top view. Here we go. We'll put it in slice mode. You can see that in top view, for example, that certain curves have control points, like the apex curve here. We say that they're edited at this point, so we can modify them by modifying the colored tangent points. And certain curves don't have control points, like the green curve here, which is the rail curve. So we can't modify it because it is calculated by interpolation, according to the points defined on the slices. And you can see that when the point of a slice has its curve edited in top view, this point now has a fixed width. You can't move it along the width here. You can only move it along the height, while the rail point has a curve which is not edited. It can be modified along the width or the height, and so this also works with curves in side view. Here in side view, you can see that the only edited curves are stringer bot and stringer top, which are the central points of the slices. And that's why the central points of the slices here cannot be modified or moved along the height, and cannot be moved along the width either, because the board is symmetrical here. And in each of these views, we can choose to edit all the curves corresponding to the point. If we want, for example, if I click here on the rail line's two arrows, I can tick the edited box and then confirm. And now we see control points appear on this green line, which let me modify the rail line directly. And in this case, the rail line on the slices can no longer be modified from left to right. It can only be modified up and down. And if then, in side view, I also choose to edit the rail curve, so we're going to display it in green too, we're going to click on Edit. It now appears here with a control point, and now the rail point on the slices is entirely determined by the top view and side view rail curves, and can no longer be moved in slice view. You will notice that in design mode, you can also choose to display the thickness between the curves. For example, here we have the thickness between the stringer top curve and the stringer bot curve, which is therefore the thickness of the board. But we can also choose to display the thickness between the rail curve and the stringer bot curve. Now we have the depth of the concavity, or V. We can multiply the Z of this thickness by whatever number we want, for example, 10 here, which allows us to better appreciate the depth of the concavity and the V. And if we go back to the properties of the rail curve, here we can choose to fix it to the stringer bot curve. Fix it to stringer bot. OK? In this case, in the thickness view, you can see control points appear on this thickness cross section, which means that we can directly modify the thickness of the concavity in this view here. And the other advantage that it has is that therefore, if I now modify the stringer bot curve in side view, the rail curve will follow. So that the depth of the concave, or the V, is not modified. And you will notice here, for example, if we display the thickness between stringer top and stringer bot, we set the vertical stretch to 1 for the true thickness. If I modify the StringerBot curve, the Stringer top curve doesn't move, and so the thickness of the slice is modified. And I could choose in the Stringer top curve settings to fix it to StringerBot. And now when I modify the slice's curve, the deck stringer curve is modified at the same time, in a way that the thickness is either not modified or barely modified. Well, I think that has already given you some good basics for starting to draw your boards. Play with the curves in design mode, and then see the result in 3D view. See you soon. Thank you.